no harm in the pot.
Get your X.
A man came from Dale's Shally Shop, bringing a man of God bread and first fruits, 20 loaves of barley and fresh ears of grain in his sack. And Elisha said, give to the man that may eat. But his servant said, how can I set this before 100 men? So he repeated, give them to the men that they may eat. For thus says the Lord, they shall eat and have some left. So he set it before them, and they ate and had some left, according to the word of the Lord. Chapter 5. Naaman, commander of the army of the king of Syria, was a great man with his master and in high favor, because by him the Lord had given victory to Syria. He was a mighty man of valor, but he was a leper. Now the Syrians, on one of their raids, had carried off a little girl from the land of Israel, and she worked in the service of Naaman's wife. She said to her mistress, would that my lord were with the prophet who is in Samaria. He would cure him of his leprosy. So Naaman went in and told his lord, thus and so spoke the girl from the land of Israel. And King of Syria said, go now, and I will send a letter to the king of Israel. So he went, taking with him 10 talents of silver, 6,000 shekels of gold, and 10 changes of clothing. And he brought the letter to the king of Israel, which read, when this letter reaches you, know that I have sent to you Naaman my servant. You may cure him of his leprosy. And when the king of Israel read the letter, he tore his clothes and said, am I God to kill and to make alive, that this man sends word to me to cure a man of his leprosy? Only consider and see how he is seeking a quarrel with me.
Cross the arms.
But when Elisha, the man of God, heard that the king of Israel had torn his clothes, he said to the king, saying, why have you torn your clothes? Let him come now to me, and he may know that there is a prophet in Israel. So Naaman came with his horses and chariots, and stood at the door of Elisha's house. And Elisha sent a messenger to him, saying, go and wash in the Jordan 7 times, and your flesh shall be restored, and you shall be clean. But Naaman was angry and went away, saying, behold, I thought that he would surely come out to me and stand and call upon the name of the Lord his God and wave his hand over the place and cure the leper. Are not Abana and Pharpar, the rivers of Damascus, better than all the waters of Israel? Could I not wash in them and be clean? So he turned and went away in a rage. And his servants came to hear and said to him, my father, it is a great word the prophet has spoken to you. Will you not do it? As he actually said to you, wash and be clean. So he went down and dipped himself 7 times in the Jordan, according to the word of the man of God. And his flesh was restored, like the flesh of a little child, and he was clean. Then he returned to the man of God, he and all his company, and he came and stood before him. And he said, behold, I know that there is no God in all the earth but in Israel. So accept now a present from your servant. But he said, as the Lord lives before whom I stand, I will receive none. And he urged him to take it, but he refused. Then Naaman said, if not, please let there be given to your servant 2 mule loads of earth. For from now on your servant will not offer burnt offering or sacrifice to any god but the Lord. In this matter, may the Lord pardon your servant. When my master goes to his house of Rimmon to worship there, leaning on my arm, and I bow myself in the house of Rimmon. When I bow myself in the house of Rimmon, the Lord pardon your servant in this matter. He said to him, go in peace. But when Naaman had gone from him a short distance, Gehazi, the servant of Elisha, the man of God, said, see, my master has spared this Naaman the Syrian, and not accepting from his hand what he brought. As the Lord lives, I will run after him and get something from him. So Gehazi followed Naaman, and when Naaman saw someone running after him, he got down from the chariot to meet him and said, is all well? And he said, all is well. My master has sent me to say, there have just come now to me from the hill country of Ephraim 2 young men of the sons of the prophet. Please give them 1 talent of silver and 2 changes of clothing. And Naaman said, be pleased to accept 2 talents. And he urged him and tied up 2 talents of silver and 2 bags with 2 changes of clothing, and laid them on 2 of his servants. And they carried them before Gehazi. And when he came to the hill, he took And he sent the men away, and they departed.
Back down.
He went in and stood before his master, and Elisha said to him,
raise that red light.
Where have you been at the time?
Up on the hill.
And he said, your servant went nowhere.
Me.
But he said to him, did not my heart go when a man turned from his chariot?
Bring that back leg, look at that knee.
Was it a time to accept money, garments, olive orchards, and vineyards?
Let's do it, push it.
Sheep and oxen, male servants and female servants.
Chest up.
Therefore, the leper said, man, I shall cling to you and to your descendants forever. So he went out from his presence, the leper, like snow.
Left leg, up, 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 toes.
Chapter six. Now the servant of the prophet said to Elisha,
me?
See, the place where we dwell under your charge is too small for us. Let us go to the Jordan, and each of us get there a log, and let us make a place for us to dwell there. And he answered, go. Then one of them said, be pleased to go with your servant. And he answered, I will go. So he went with them. And when they came to the Jordan, they cut down trees. But as one was felling a log, his axe fell into the water, and he cried out, alas, my master, it was barren. Then the man of God said, where did it fall? When he showed him the place, he cut off a stick and threw it in there and made the iron flow. And he said, take it up. But he reached out his hand and took it. Once when the king of Syria was warring against Israel, he took counsel with his servant, saying, at such and such a place, everyone came. The man of God sent word to the king of Israel, be aware that you do not pass this place, and the Syrians are going down. And the king of Israel sent to the place about which the man of God told him. But as he used to warn him, so that he saved himself there more than once or twice. But the mind of the king of Syria was greatly troubled because of this thing, and he called his servants and said to them, will you not show me who of us is for the king of Israel? But the servant said, none, my lord, O king, but Elisha the prophet who is in Israel, tells the king of Israel the words that he's speaking of them. And he said, go and see where he is, that I may send and seize him. He was told him, behold, he is in Dothan. So he sent their horses and chariots and a great army, and they came by night and surrounded the city. And the servant of the man of God rose early in the morning and went out. Behold, an army with horses and chariots was all around the city. And the servant said, alas, my master, what shall we do? He said, do not be afraid. Those who are with
take
us
your time, everybody.
More than those who are with
us. Use it if you need it.
Then Elisha prayed and said, O Lord, please open his eyes that he may see. So the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots and fire all around Elisha. And when the Syrians came down against him, Elisha prayed to the Lord, he said, please strike this people with blindness. So he struck them with blindness in accordance with the prayer of Elisha.
It's your last push-up.
And Elisha said to them, this is not the way, and this is not the city. Follow me, and I will bring you to the man that you seek. And he led them to Samaria. As soon as they entered Samaria, Elisha said, O Lord, open the eyes of these men, that they may see. And the Lord opened their eyes, and they saw, and behold, they were in the midst of Samaria. As soon as the king of Israel saw them, he said to Elisha, my father, shall I strike them down? Shall I strike them down?
He answered,
you shall not strike them down. Would you strike down those whom you have taken captive with your sword and with your bow? Set bread and water before him, that they may eat and drink and go to their master.
Listen to it.
And he prepared for them a great feast, and when they had eaten and drunk, he sent them away, and they went to their master. And the Syrians did not come again on the way into the land of Israel. Afterwards, in Hazor, king of Syria, mustered his entire army and led out into the siege of Samaria. And there was a great famine in Samaria, and they besieged it, until a donkey's head was sold for 80 shekels of silver, and a fourth part of a cow and dove's dung for 5 shekels of silver. Now, as the king of Israel was passing by on the wall, the woman cried out to him, saying, help, my lord, O king. And he said, if the Lord will not help you, how shall I help you? From the threshing floor or from the winepress? And the king answered,
use it a little bit.
And they said to one another, we are not doing right. This day is a day of good news. If we are silent and waiting for more of life, punishment will overtake us. Let us go and tell the king's household. And the Haman called to the people of the city and told them, if we came to the camp of the Syrians, behold, one of these seen the first. And the horses tied and the dogs tied and the cats as they were. Then the gatekeepers called out, and it was told within the king's household. And the king brought it to the night and said to his servant, I will tell you what the Syrians have done here. They know that we are hungry. Therefore, they have gone out of the camp, and hide themselves in their own country. When they come out of the city, we shall take them alive and bring them to the city. And one of his servants said, let some men take five of the remaining horses. Seeing that those who are left here will fare like the whole multitude of Israel who have already fallen. Let us send and see. So they took two horses, and the king sent them after the army of the Syrians and said, go and see. So they went after them as far as the Jordan. Behold, all the way, the Syrians and soldiers and equipment, and the Syrians have thrown away their homes. And some of them returned back home to him. Then the people went out and plundered the Syrians. So a seal of fine flour was sold for a shekel, and 2 seals of barley for a shekel, according to the word of the Lord. Now the king had appointed a captain on whose hand he ruled to have charge of the gate. And the people trampled him in the gate, so that he died, as the man of God had said when the king came down to him. For when the man of God had said to him, 2 seals of barley shall be sold for a shekel, a fine flower for a shekel, and got this guy tomorrow in the gate of the Lord. And the captain had answered the man of God, if the Lord himself should make windows and all the rest of the second of the week. And he had said, you shall see it with your own mind, but you shall not use it. And so it happened to him, the people trampled him on the gate, and he died. Chapter 4. Now Elijah had said to him, the king of Syria destroy Judah for the sake of David, his servant, since he promised to give a land to him and to his sons forever.
Let's keep going, kick it out a little bit.
In his days, Edom revolted from the rule of Judah and set up a king of their own. Then Joram passed over to Zayin with all his chariots and rose by night. And his chariot commanders struck the Edomites who had surrounded him, but his army fled home. So Edom revolted from the rule of Judah to this day. Then Libnah revolted at the same time. Now the rest of the acts of Joram and all that he did, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the kings of Judah? So Joram said that his fathers was buried with his fathers in the city of David, and Ahaziah his son reigned in his place. In the 12th year of Joram, the son of Ahab, king of Israel, Ahaziah the son of Jehoram, king of Judah, began to reign. Ahaziah was 22 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 1 year in Jerusalem. His mother's name was Athaliah. He was a granddaughter of Amram, king of Israel.
You see those knuckles?
He also walked in the way of the house of Ahab, and did what was evil in the sight of the Lord, as the house of Ahab had done, for he was son in law to the house of Ahab. He went with Joram, the son of Ahab, to make war against Hazael, king of Syria, at Ramoth Gilead. And the Syrians wounded Joram. King Joram returned to be healed in Jezreel of the wounds that the Syrians had given him of them, when he fought against Hazael, king of Syria. And Ahaziah, the son of Jehoram, king of Judah, went down to see Joram, the son of Ahab, in Jezreel, because he was sick. Chapter 9. Then Elisha the prophet called one of the sons of the prophets and said to him, tie up your garments and take this flask of oil in your hand and go to Ramoth Gilead. And you arrive, look there for Jabez, the son of Jehoshaphat, son of Nimshah. And go in and cut your thighs from among his fellows and lead him to a inner chamber. And take the flask of oil and pour it on his head and say, thus says the Lord, I anoint you king.
See my foot right here, can I be square?
Then open the door and leave. Do not linger.
Some people like that before.
For the young man, the servant of the prophet, went to Ramoth Gilead. And when he came, behold, the commanders of the army were in council. Then he said, I have a word for you, O commander. Jabez said, to which of us all?
And he said,
two people, O commander.
Three.
So he arose and went into the house, and the young man poured the oil on his head, saying to him, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, I anoint you king over the people of the Lord, over Israel, and you shall strike down the house of Ahab your master, for the final avenger of Jezebel, the blood of my servants and prophets, and the blood of all the servants of the Lord, for the whole house of Ahab shall perish. And I will cut off from Ahab every male, bond, or flea in Israel. And I will make the house of Ahab like the house of Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, and like the house of Baasha, the son of Ahijah. And the dogs shall eat Jezebel in the territory of Jezreel. And men shall bury her. Then he opened the door and fled. When Jehu came out to the servants of his master, they said to him, is all well? Why did this mad fellow come to you? And he said to them, you know the fellow and his talk. And they said, is that true? And he said, thus and so he spoke to me, saying, thus says the Lord, I anoint you king over Israel. Then in haste every man of them took his garment and put it under him on the bear steps, and they blew the trumpet and proclaimed, Jehu is king. Thus Jehu, the son of Jehoshaphat, the son of Nimshi, conspired against Joram. Now Joram, with all Israel, had been on guard at Ramoth Gilead against Hazael, king of Syria. But King Joram had returned to be healed in Jezreel of the wounds that the Syrians had given him when he fought with Hazael, king of Syria. So Jehu said, if this is your decision, then let no one slip out of the city to go and tell the news in Jezreel. Then Jehu mounted his chariot and went to Jezreel, where Joram lay there. And Ahaziah, king of Judah, had come down to visit Joram. Now the watchman was standing on the tower of Jezreel, and he saw the company of Jehu as he came, and said, I see a company. And Joram said, take a horseman and send to meet him, and let him say, is it peace? So a man on horseback went to meet him and said, thus says the turn around and ride behind him. And watch my reporter say, the messenger reached them, but he is not coming back. Then he sent out a second horseman who came to them and said, thus the king has said, is it peace? Jehu answered, why do you have to do with peace? Turn around and ride behind him. Again, the watchman reported, we reached him, but he is not coming back. And the driving is like the driving of Jehu, the son of Nimshi, for he drives furiously. Joram said, make ready. And he made ready his chariot. Then Joram, king of Israel, and Ahaziah, king of Judah, set out, each in his chariot, and went to meet Jehu, and met him at the property of Naboth the Jezreel. And when Joram saw Jehu, he said, is it peace, Jehu? He answered, what peace can there be so long as the whorings and the sorceries of your mother Jezebel are so many? Then Joram reined about and fled, saying to Ahaziah, treachery, O Ahaziah. And Jehu drew his bow with his full strength and shot Joram between the shoulders. But the barrel pierced his heart, and he sank in his chariot. Jehu said, take him up and throw him on the plot of ground belonging to Naboth the Jezreelite. For remember when you and I rode side by side behind Ahab his father, how the Lord made this pronouncement against him. As surely as I saw yesterday the blood of Naboth and the blood of his son, declares the Lord, I will repay you on this plot of ground. Now therefore take him up and throw him on the plot of ground in accordance with the word of the Lord. When Ahaziah, the king of Judah, saw this, he fled in the direction of Beth-Hagon. And Jehu pursued him and said, shoot him also. And they shot him in the chariot at the ascent of Zur, which is by Hidden. And he fled to the Giddo and died there. His servants carried him in a chariot to Jerusalem and buried him in his tomb with his fathers in the city of David. In the 11th year of Joram, the son of Ahab, Ahaziah began to reign over Judah. When Jehu came to Jezreel, Jezebel heard of him, and she painted her eyes and adorned her head and looked out of the window. And as Jehu entered the gate, she says, is it peace, you Zimri, murderer of your master? And he lifted up his face to the window and said, who is on my side? Who? Two or three eunuchs came out. He said, throw her down. So they threw her down, and some of her blood spattered on the wall and on the horses, and they trampled on her. Then he went in and ate and drank. And he said, see after this cursed woman and bury her, for she is a king's daughter. But when they went to bury her, they found no more of her than the skull and the head and the palms of her hand. When they came back and told him, he said, this is the word of the Lord which he spoke by his servant Elijah the Tishbite. In the territory of Jezreel, the dog shall eat the flesh of Jezebel, and the corpse of Jezebel shall be as dung on the face of the beard in the territory of Jezreel. But no one can say, this is Jezebel. Chapter 10. Now Ahab had 70 sons in Samaria. So Jehu wrote letters and sent them to Samaria, to the rulers of the city, to the elders, and to the guardians of the sons of Ahab, saying, now then, as soon as this letter comes to you, seeing your master's sons are with you, and there are with you chariots and horses, fortified cities also, and weapons, select the best and the fittest of your master's sons, and set him on his father's throne, and fight for your master's house. But they were exceedingly afraid, and said, oh, behold, the two kings could not stand before him. How then can we stand? So he who was over the palace, and he who was over the city, together with the elders and the guardians, sent to Jehu, saying, we are your servants, and we will do all that you tell us. We will not make anyone king. We do whatever is good in your eyes. Then he wrote to them a second letter, saying, if you are on my side, and if you are ready to obey me, take the heads of your master's sons and come to me at Jezreel tomorrow at this time. Now the king said, 70 persons, or with the great men of the city, who were bringing them out. And as soon as the letter came to them, they took the king's sons and slaughtered them, 70 persons, and put their heads in baskets, and sent them to him at Jezreel. When the messenger came and told him, they had brought the heads of the king's sons. He said, lay them in two heaps at the entrance of the gate until the morning. Then in the morning, when he went out, he stood and said to all the people, you are innocent. It was I who conspired against my master. I killed him. But who struck down all these? For the Lord has done what he said on his servant Elijah. So Jehu struck down all the remaining of the house of Ahab in Jezreel, all the great men, his close friends, and his priests, till he left it to them to make it. Then he set out and went to Samaria. On the way, when he was at Bethlehem, the shepherd, Jehu met the relatives of Ahaziah, king of Judah, and he said, who are you? And they answered, we are the relatives of Ahaziah, who came down to visit the royal princes and the sons of the queen mother. He said, take them alive. And they took them alive and slaughtered them at the pit of Bethlehem, 42 persons, and he spared none of them. And when he departed from there, he met Jehonadab, the son of Rechab, coming to meet him. And he greeted him and said to him, is your heart true to my heart as mine is yours? Jehu said, if it is, give me your hand. So he gave him his hand. And Jehu took him up with him into the chariot. And he said, come with me and see my zeal for the Lord. So he had him ride in his chariot. When he came to Samaria, he struck down all the remains of Ahab in Samaria. And he wiped them out, according to the word of the Lord that he spoke to Elijah. Then Jehu assembled all the people and said to them, Ahab served Baal a little, but Jehu will serve him much. Now therefore, call to me all the prophets of Baal, all his worshippers, and all his priests. Let none be missing, for I have a great sacrifice to offer to Baal. Whoever is missing shall not live. But Jehu did it with cunning in order to destroy the worshippers of Baal. And Jehu ordered, sanctify a solemn assembly for Baal. So they proclaimed it. And Jehu sent throughout all Israel, and all the worshippers of Baal came, but there was not a man left who did not come. They entered the house of Baal, and the house of Baal was filled from one end to the other. He said to him who was in charge of the wardrobe, bring out the vestments for all the worshippers of Baal. So he brought out the vestments for them. Then Jehu went to the house of Baal with Jehonadab, the son of Rechab. And he said to the worshippers of Baal, search and see that there is no servant of the Lord here among you, but only the worshippers of Baal. Then they went in to offer sacrifice and burnt offering. And Jehu had stationed 50 men outside and said, the man who allows any of those whom I give into your hands to escape shall forfeit his life. So as soon as he had made an end of offering the burnt offering, Jehu said to the guard and to the officers, go in and strike them down. Let not a man escape. So when they put them to the sword, the guard and the officers cast them out and went into the inner room of the house of Baal. And they brought out the pillar that was in the house of Baal and burned it. They demolished the pillar of Baal and demolished the house of Baal and made it a latrine for his dead. Thus Jehu wiped out Baal from Israel. But Jehu did not turn aside from the sins of Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, which he made Israel to sin. That is the golden calves that were rebelled in Dan. And the Lord said to Jehu, because you have done well in carrying out what is right in my eyes, and have done to the house of Ahab according to all that is in my heart, your sons of the fourth generation shall sit on the throne of Israel. But Jehu was not careful to walk in the law of the Lord, the God of Israel, with all his heart. He did not turn from the sins of Jeroboam, which he made Israel to sin. In those days, the Lord began to cut off parts of Israel. Hazael defeated them throughout the territory of Israel, from the Jordan eastward, all the land of Gilead, the Gadites, and the Reubenites, and the Manassites, from Aroer, which is by the valley of Yarna, that is Gilead and Bashan. Now the rest of the acts of Jehu and all that he did, and all his might, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the kings of Israel? So Jehu slept with his fathers, and they buried him in Samaria. And Jehoahaz, his son, reigned. Samaria was 28 years.
All by them. Turn it out. Sink to the other side. Big stretch.
Chapter 11.
Reach out.
Now when Athaliah, the mother of Ahaziah, saw that her son was dead, she arose and destroyed all the royal family. But Jehoshaphat, the daughter of King Joram, sister of Ahaziah, took Joash, the son of Ahaziah, and stole him away from among the king's sons, who were being put to death. And she put him and his nurse in a bedroom. Thus they hid him from Athaliah, so that he was not put to death. And he remained with her 6 years, hidden in the house of the Lord, while Athaliah reigned over the land. But in the seventh year, Jehoiada sent and brought the captains of the Karaites and of the guards, and had them come to him in the house of the Lord. And he made a covenant with them, and put them under oath in the house of the Lord. And he showed them the king's sons, and he commanded them, "This is the thing that you shall do. One third of you, those who come off duty on the Sabbath, guard the king's house, another third being at the gate to serve, and a third at the gate behind the guards, shall guard the palace. Two divisions of you, which come on duty in force on the Sabbath and guard the house of the Lord on behalf of the king, shall surround the king, each with his weapons in his hand. And whoever approaches the ranks is to be put to death.
Where's my chair?
Oh, my chair.
Be with the king when he goes out and when he comes in." The captains did according to all that Jehoiada the priest commanded. And they each brought his men who were to go on duty on the Sabbath. Those who would come on duty on the Sabbath, and they came to Jehoiada the priest. And the priest gave to the captains the spears and shields that had been King David's, which were in the house of the Lord. And the guards stood, every man with his weapons in his hand, from the south side of the house to the north side of the house. And the altar of the house on behalf of the king.
In the position, everybody's ready.
Then he brought out the king's son, and put the crown on him, and gave him the testimony. They proclaimed him the king and anointed him. They clapped their hands and said, "Long live the king." When Athaliah heard the noise of the guard and of the people, she went into the house of the Lord to the people. And when she looked, there was the king standing by the pillar, according to the custom. And the captains and the trumpeters beside the king, and all the people of the land rejoicing and blowing trumpets. And Athaliah tore her clothes and cried, "Treason, treason." Then Jehoiada the priest commanded the captains who were set over the army, "Bring her out between the ranks and put to death with the sword anyone who follows her." For the priest said, "Let her not be put to death in the house of the Lord." So they laid hands on her, and she went through the horse's entrance to the king's house, and there she was put to death. And Jehoiada made a covenant between the Lord and the king and people, that they should be the Lord's people, and also between the king and the people. And all the people of the land went to the house of Baal and tore it down, his altars and his images they broke in pieces, and they killed Mattan, the priest of Baal, before the altars. And the priest posted watchmen over the house of the Lord. And he took the captains, the Karaites, the guards, and all the people of the land, and they brought the king down from the house of the Lord, marching through the gate and the guards to the king's house. And he took his seat on the throne of the king. So all the people of the land rejoiced, and the city was quiet after Athaliah had been put to death with the sword at the king's house. Jehoash was 7 years old when he began to reign.
He need a break. Hit the pause button. This is number 7.
Chapter 12. In the seventh year of Jehu, Jehoash began to reign, and he reigned 40 years in Jerusalem.
Now remember, if you need
his mother's name was Zibiah,
your head,
Beersheba. And Jehoash did what was right in the eyes of the Lord all his days, because Jehoiada the priest instructed him. Nevertheless, the high places were not taken away. The people continued to sacrifice and make offerings on the high places. Jehoash said to the priest, "All the money and the holy things that is brought into the house of the Lord, the money for which each man is assessed, the money from the assessment of a person, and the money that a man's heart prompts him to bring into the house of the Lord, let the priests take each from his donor, and let them repair the house wherever any need of repairs is discovered." But by the 23rd year of King Jehoash, the priests had made no repairs on the house. Therefore King Jehoash summoned Jehoiada the priest and the other priests and said to them, "Why are you not repairing the house? Now therefore take no more money repair the house. So the priests agreed that they should take no more money from the people, and that they should not repair the house.
Now, rest for a second.
Then Jehoiada the priest took a chest and bored a hole in the lid of it, and set it beside the altar on the right side as one entered the house of the Lord.
Ready, go.
The priests who guarded the threshold put in it all the money that was brought into the house of the Lord. And whenever they saw that there was much money in the chest, the king's secretary and the high priest came up, and they bagged and counted the money that was found in the house of the Lord. Then they would give the money that was weighed out into the hands of the workmen who had the oversight of the house of the Lord. They paid it out to the carpenters and the builders who worked on the house of the Lord, and to the masons and the stone cutters, as well as to buy timber and quarry stone for the repairs on the house of the Lord, and for any outlay for the repairs of the house. But there were not made for the house of the Lord basins of silver, snuffers, bowls, trumpets, or any vessels of gold or of silver from the money that was brought into the house of the Lord, for that was given to the workmen who were repairing the house of the Lord with it. And they did not ask for an accounting from the men into whose hand they delivered the money to pay out to the workmen, for they dealt honestly. The money from the guilt offering, the money from the sin offering, was not brought into the house of the Lord. It belonged to the priest. At that time, Hazael, king of Syria, went up and fought against Gad and took it. But when Hazael set his face to go up against Jerusalem, Jehoash, king of Judah, took all the sacred gifts that Jehoshaphat and Jehoram and Ahaziah, his father, kings of Judah, had dedicated, and his own sacred gift, and all the gold that was found in the treasuries of the house of the Lord and of the king's house, and sent these to Hazael, king of Syria. Then Hazael went away from Jerusalem. Now the rest of the acts of Joash and all that he did, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the kings of Judah? His servants arose and made a conspiracy and struck down Joash in the house of Milon on the way they drove down to Silla. It was Josachar the son of Shimeah and Jehozabad the son of Shomer, his servants, who struck him down so that he died. And the arrogance of his fathers in the city of Israel, and Amaziah his son reigned in his place.
There you go. Number 1, 2, Cardi Lash. Nice
work. In the 23rd year of Joash, the son of Ahaziah, king of Judah, Jehoahaz,